Shalom, good evening. A few words about the concept of Pidyon HaBen, the redemption of the firstborn. We mentioned this concept many times, but lately one of my friends eclaired my eyes, opened my eyes about the fact that the ceremony of Pidyon HaBen called in the Talmud, Yeshua HaBen. Yeshua HaBen. Yeshua the Son. Right, so any ceremony of Pidyon HaBen, it's called in the Talmud, the Son Yeshua. It means every born, every firstborn that we redeem with the priest, represents the concept of Yeshua the Son. Right, so this expression appear in the book of Baba Kama, in the Talmud, in the page 80, the first page of page 80, in the end of the page, in the end of the first page 80, in the Talmud, Baba Kama. First gate. It's in Baba Kama.
It's in both Yerushalmi and Bavli?
No, I talk about only the Bavli. Baba Kama. Okay, so this expression appears there, and Rashi writes explanation, a comment that he says that Yeshua Ben this the way they call. The act of the ceremony of Pidyon HaBen, redemption of the firstborn.
Do we know when was this written, this chapter of the Talmud?
The Talmud was signed before 600 years for the counting, for the Sphira.
Before or
after?
After.
Of course.
It's like year 600.
600 years it was signed. When it was exactly written, I don't know. Mm-hmm.
It's after Jesus, after Yeshua.
Of course. It means it was a traditional...
Tradition.
Tradition that is the way we call this ceremony.
So there may be a connection with the story of Yeshua, Jesus, here.
At least with Ashgacha Pratit, with God, its connection from God. That make this connection. I don't think that it's a connection that the Jews today will want to point on it. I never heard about this that this is the way we call the ceremony. It means this is the way we call the sun that we do to in Pidyon HaBen. By myself, you know, I say that what the fact that we want to redeem Jesus is like Pidyon HaBen. We say that it's more like Esav that selling the birthright to Yaakov. But we say that it's something similar to Pidyon HaBen. But the fact that we call Pidyon HaBen Yeshua Ben, this means it's completely a right to call this Pidyon HaBen. People sometimes ask me, why you have to do Pidyon HaBen to Jesus? He have already Pidyon HaBen when he was 1 month. His father did to him what the Torah ordered to do Pidyon HaBen.
So what is your answer?
So it's not the same kind of Pidyon HaBen, of course. I don't talk about to do Pidyon HaBen to Jesus that is just born and he is 1 month old, and he belong to the priest, and his father have to redeem him from the priest. He have to give him the 5 shkalim. So I don't talk about this kind of Pidyon HaBen, but still it's something similar. We redeem a son, but from
back to the family.
we redeem a son in Pidyon HaBen, and we do something similar of redeeming Jesus. Similar, and we do it with the priest the same way. Right, so this teach me that it's more of similarity.
How do you explain this, that the Pidyon HaBen is called Yeshua Ben, huh? Can you just...
I don't know. This is what they call it. Why they call it like this?
It's a symbol, it's a very strong
symbol. Maybe somebody tried to tell us something that his soul have to be redeemed one day, like this kid have to come back to Am Israel, he have to be redeemed one day by the priest. Mm. So he put it in the Talmud.
They knew something.
It's like somebody knew something and he put it there. All right, so
it's not that taboo, you know, it's kind of breaking the taboo.
You know, all the taboo is called cherem. It is written, kol cherem lechaye. Every cherem belongs to the priest. It is written. All right, so what is taboo, what is was given to God, we cannot use it. It belongs to the priest. It's called cherem. We cannot use it. Jesus was sold to the priest. In the moment he was given to the priest, he cannot be used anymore by the Jewish. He was sold to the priest, he belonged to the priest.
Eventually the nations.
The same thing. He belonged to God. He don't belong anymore to Am Israel. Okay? So he have to be redeemed. So it belongs to the priest. You know what is the gematria of Yeshua Ben? HaKohen HaMashiach. So it's not, it completely belongs to the priest. He's a priest. Alright? He has the holiness of the priesthood. He's a priest Mashiach. Now we have to redeem him. We have to redeem to be Mashiach for Am Yisrael, not only for the priest. We have to redeem him from the priesthood. It's like we have to redeem him from the nation, the same thing. Alright, so... the Kohen Mashiach 443. The same thing. Okay, so we see now very clearly the connection between the concept of Pidyon HaBen that we want to do to Jesus and to the ceremony of Pidyon HaBen that we do for a kid.
So perhaps it's also his own ceremony when he's supposed to come back to Israel. It's a memory, it's a stamp of his own return.
Yes.
Left in the Talmud.
Exactly, exactly.
Like
it's a very strong hint that we call this ceremony Yeshua Ben. Jesus the Son. In the Talmud.
Are there other mentions of Yeshua in the Talmud? About himself?
They call him Yeshua in the Talmud.
Yes.
Here it is written Yeshua, not Yehoshua.
That's why I'm asking.
This is so fantastic hint. It's not Yeshua. Yeshua, it's like the curse. Yeshua, it means the second coming of Jesus. It means Yeshua with Esav, it means the two force together. It's what means the Ein is Jesus, and is the Ein that is two Jewish. Ein equal two time Yehudi, the two force. The sun and the moon, etc. Jesus with the two force have to be redeemed.
Is there other mention of Yeshua, full name in the Talmud, or this is the only one?
Maybe it is Yeshua is a name that appears in the Bible, so it can be that Yeshua appear in different places in the Talmud.
Yeah, but this context is special.
I didn't check if appear if the name Yeshua appear in any place in all the Talmud. I can make a search. Let me see if I can check it now. 1 second. It can be that it is the appearance of Yeshua in the Talmud, but it's not Jesus. They don't talk about Jesus.
Yeah.
It is the Yeshua, the big priest in the in the time of Zechariah, etc. So
it's not relevant for now.
But if it is the only place that it is written the name Yeshua in the Talmud, it's something.
And you know what's written before and after this Yeshua then?
It's something very meaningful if this is the only Yeshua in all the Talmud.
Yeah.
I will tell you immediately.
But also it could be interesting the context of what is before and after Yeshua ben. Ariel?
Ma?
I was saying that perhaps it's interesting the context, what is before and after this mention of Yeshua ben.
No, it's not something interesting. I didn't find really. It just by the way they mention. No, it is written the name Yeshua in the time that have to do with the time of Zerubbabel and Nehemiah. So there are different names in the Talmud. They don't talk about Jesus. Jesus in the Talmud, they call him Yeshu.
Mm-hmm.
But when they talk about this ceremony, they call it Yeshua Ben. All right, so it's two words that...
Ha-ben,
Ben.
How do you understand the Ben? Ben is the
Ben
son.
Ben is the son.
The son of who?
If we talk about Yeshua, it's what we call the son of God.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, every son of Israel is a son of God. Like Jesus said, you are all God and all son of God. All right, so.
And how do I understand this from the Torah and Hasidut point of view, the son of God? How can
I explained this many times that son of God is Nitzotz Katan Boresh and Ya Nitzotz Katan Nivra. It's a small spark of the Creator that becomes a small spark of create.
Of the creation.
Of that being created.
Being created.
All right, so Nivra, Livro, it came from the word Bar, what it means son. All right, so it's something that go out, like a baby that go out of the womb of his mother. And it's what it means, libare, to go out. All right, so this was about the redemption of the firstborn, what we have to do soon with God's help. Thank you.